My bad, my bad. That was one of my good neighbors. He just wanted to speak to me. You know, I like being around neighbors that actually like speak, that actually like communicating. You know, I like that. I like that good energy. But my next couple of YouTubers, DDG Cool, he just dropped a couple of videos that I put on my page on how to like how to get your YouTube monetized. How to like, he was explaining the fact that you don't need a camera to sit there and be a YouTuber. He basically was like, let YouTube pay for your camera. So at first I'm thinking like in my head, like, man, I need a camera. I need to be like the rest of them YouTubers. Man, I really need a camera. I need a good laptop so I can have Final Cut Pro. I need all of that. But then he started putting in my head like, man, you don't need that. I mean, I had been already thought like, man, I don't really need it. I got my phone on. Then I'm thinking about like space, and I'm thinking about like all these videos I'm finna put on my thing. It ain't gonna look right. The thumbnails ain't gonna be perfect. But that's just me rushing it. So it's like, if I take my time with it and I do put the enough energy into what I want to do, which is YouTube, it's like eventually I'm gonna get there. Eventually I'm gonna touch somebody that know how to do thumbnails better than me, and that can help me out with that somehow, some way, in God's name. You know, I'm gonna have somebody that know how to hold the camera perfectly and get all my pranks right, and get all my, and get all the angles right for my pranks while I'm doing them. Or, you know what I'm saying, one day I might meet a couple of friends that actually want to be in the videos with me. I got friends that actually want to be in videos, but our schedules on work is totally different. So it's like, I gotta catch them on a good time. I got a homie that's a tattoo artist. She down for whatever I'm whatever. She down for whatever I'm down for. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, our schedules on two different paths, so I don't hold her for that. You know, that's my homie. That's my best friend. I love her. But we gonna get, y'all gonna see her soon in the videos. Yeah, and Earl on Demand, she's a great YouTuber too. She basically teaches you about how to promote your business on YouTube. She teaches you on how to get your business started, and she's actually a great teacher with also teaching people how to get your YouTube monetized. And I like that too. I love when people teach you how to get your YouTube monetized, because it's like, if you know some information that I don't know, or if you notice something that I'm doing wrong and you can't individually get to me because of the simple fact it's millions of people that's in your inbox, it's millions of people that's watching you, put it out there so the world can see, so others can know, because ain't no point in you holding it to yourself, because then it's like, for what? Why you holding the Krabby Patty formula? Like, why is you holding it from me? I want to make the same Krabby Patty you make, but you scared that I might make it a little better than you. I might make a little more money than you. And now you holding it hostage because you don't want to seem like, you don't want to make it feel like I'm on top of you or something. And it's not about that. And that's what's wrong with us now. Like, too many people think that, oh, if she get on top of me, she going to be better than me. She going to be doing it way better than what I was doing it. She going to be making more money than me, instead of thinking like, if I help this person out, we're going to be here. You know what I'm saying? She look over my shoulder, I look over her shoulder. You know, it's basically y'all building each other. You know what I'm saying? And not on no relationship type stuff, but on a friendship tip. So it's like, I just built me a friend out of the blue that I didn't know. I just built me a relationship with somebody that I didn't know. You know what I'm saying? So now it's like, y'all like this. I know it's a lot of snakes in the grass. It's a lot of people that watch you grow and get big and then do something to bring you back down, but that's why I put it out there so much, of the simple fact that find people that bring you good energy. You know what I'm saying? Like, find people that want to see you just on the same path as they is. Find people that actually want to see you do better in life. You know what I'm saying? I always put out there to my friends like, hey, yeah, you know what I'm saying, blessings to you, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm not that friend that's like, bro, the way you going, like, ooh, all this negative energy type stuff, I don't bring that to my friends, because I be feeling that stuff. I be feeling negative energy. I be feeling bad vibes. I tell my little cousins, I tell my little brother, I tell even the young kids that come around me, that love being around me, they no younger than probably 8. I tell them all the time, if we get into it or something like that, or, you know, not really getting into it, but you know how kids is, I tell them all the time, like, if you feeling like you got something wrong with you, if you feel like you have some type of bad spirit, or you're not feeling like you want to be bothered today or something going through your mind, you can come talk to me. We can talk. We can sit down and talk. You know what I'm saying? I could sit down. Even you could be 10 years old. You could sit down and you could talk to me about what's going on in your mind. You could tell me about what it is you feeling. You know what I'm saying? But don't come around and don't have that bad energy, because it's only going to feed to you, and it's going to linger on me. And now I'm having a good day. I'm enjoying myself. And now you got this bad energy, this bad spirit. And now this bad spirit just jumped on my shoulder. And now I'm groggy as ever. And I'm mad too. It's like, you know, you don't want that. You want somebody that's going to be like, hey, what's up? What you doing? Ooh, that's, you know what I'm saying? Something with the good energy. Coming around with the good vibes. You don't always want to hear no negative stuff. Negative, 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 negative. You know what I'm saying? You want to hear that positive, positive. I'm not saying every day going to be a good day either. I'm not saying that. But for a whole month, I don't want to hear every day of that month that JoJo just cheated on you. Joe just got another girl pregnant. Joe did that. Joe did that. For a whole month, if you can't see that you deserve better, that you're worth way more, that you value, that your value in his life ain't nothing, and that it'll be something to somebody else, and that somebody else will come in your life and cherish the ground you walk on. If you can't see that within yourself, then something wrong, because it's just like you accepting it now. It'll been happening for 30 to 60 days. Now it's acceptable. Now you accepting it. You feeding into that. It turns you on. So now it's like there's nothing that I can say to you to make you get away from that negative energy. So instead of me telling you every day being your friend that you need to get away from that, now it's like I need to separate myself from you, because it's like you're not getting it. You're not saying that you're worth more. You're not saying that your value is way more than what Joe giving you. I don't need to keep hearing that. Being a friend, I don't. I could tell you once or I could tell you five times, leave that man alone, because he ain't gonna do better. You still gonna be around him. You still gonna come around me because he making you feel bad. Now you gonna come bring it off on me. I don't even want to hear it. You know, I've been in relationships where people just didn't see my worth. People didn't see my value. I ain't gonna lie. I used to be like, oh, I forgive you. It's so, you know, we could be back together. It's okay. Now I'm like, bro, I could bring some stuff to the table. If I could bring the knives, the spoons, and the forks. If you can't bring the plates and the cups, I don't. Man, I'm good on you. No cap. I'm definitely good. Like, if I mess up, and I'm not saying I'm going to go out here and cheat, but if I mess up and you can't see that I'm trying to fix myself for the better of me, but to make us stronger, and you can't see that I'm the type of person where I feel like, okay, we having a problem. I want to sit down and talk to you. I want to sit down and be your woman, and I want to speak with you as a grown woman, and I want to speak with you as your lover, and I want to speak to you as your soulmate. I want to speak to you as your best friend. I want to speak to you as your friend, or I want to speak to you as us being a couple. You can't see that I'm trying to do that to better us as a whole. Then I don't need no parts. Don't text me as a friend. Don't ask me to be my friend, because I'm good on all of that, yo. Like, I'm good. I don't want it. I don't want none of that, because it's only going to make me think, like, why are you here? Like, what's your point? You're wasting my time, and I definitely don't need you. I'm getting older. I don't need somebody that's going to just sit in my face and, hi, friend. What are we doing? No. I'm good with the friend I got, with the friends I got. I'm good with the people that I got that's my family, that show me the love. I'm good with my friend, my homie that I got, that show me the love. We go out, we do trips, we do all of that. I want people to be around me that's gonna show me better. My homie taught me about designer t-shirts and how to design my own t-shirt. If you ain't got friends that's trying to put you on a path of learning something, X them out. My homie tried to put me on piercings. My homie tried to teach me the tattoo. My homie tried to teach me how to design my own t-shirt. She showed me the ropes on how to get them done. All of that. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, but with piercing, I was into it, but I'm kind of scared of poking people. And I don't even like needles myself. So let alone to hold a needle and put it through somebody else's skin and hear that pop. I wasn't trying to really do that. But tattooing seemed pretty dope. It just takes a lot of time and patience, but patience patience with me is still something I'm working on within my inner self, because I ain't got none really. But yeah, other than that, I ain't gonna hold y'all too long. I don't want to make the video too long. Just wanted to put something out there, especially for the younger people that watch, especially for the people in the middle age, and especially for people my age. You know what I'm saying? I kind of was like all over the place, but I just wanted to put it out there. And the only reason why y'all been seeing me wear a mask for like months and a lot of my videos is because this COVID-19 stuff has not ended. I got younger people that live with me that I can't get sick. I can't risk getting sick. I have family members that I can't get sick at all, and I love dearly, and I wouldn't ever want to see them go through that, God forbid. And I want to protect myself. It's like a lot of y'all out here without the mask on, and it's like, bro, why? Y'all see me in a car, but it's because either I'm just now leaving the store and I feel like pulling over, parking, talking, or, you know what I'm saying, I'm just getting off of my shift and we gotta wear these all day, so it's like, what's the point of taking it off? I'm gonna do a video real quick. You know what I'm saying? Or it's like, I'm finna go into a store and I don't wanna forget this, cause you know how that walk back to the car is when you in line and got everything, or when you just walk that long walk through the parking lot to even get in the store, to stand in line and still forget your mask for them to tell you to turn around and go get it. It's like, yeah, might as well have it on. But anyways, I'm gone. Y'all already know. Blessings to y'all. Warrior gang. You know what I'm saying? You did.